as a space shuttle astronaut, I flew the space shuttle 5 times. Every one of those was on the redesigned rocket motor that proved itself to be the most reliable rocket motor in the world. So this motor we're looking at here is called the qualification motor number 1. And it's actually the 4th motor in a series. We had 3 development motors. And on the development motors, they really are development, where you start out conservatively, you do a test firing, you see how well the insulators worked, how much thrust, what was the performance of the motor really, and then you start optimizing it.
So QM1 is the first of 2 tests that will be used to qualify the motors for flight. We're actually already building the pieces of the 2nd qualification motor flight. This is a really exciting time for all of us here. Coming off of Orion's first flight test in December, less than a month later, we had the new RS-25 engines, which are the liquid engines that will power the rocket, have been tested at Stennis with a brand new state-of-the-art controller. The pieces of the rocket itself, the core, almost 30 feet in diameter, are all being manufactured at Michoud as we speak. There's a company called Conrad down in South Louisiana. They took our Pegasus barge, which is the barge we use to move the external tank around during the space shuttle days. They had to cut it in half and add 65 feet and stiffen it up to be able to handle the massive core that will come out of Michoud near New Orleans to be shipped down to KSC. And then in a few months, we'll actually complete the critical design review of the Space Launch System. This is where we actually say we are now done designing and it's time to start putting all this hardware together and running it through its tests and verifying that it actually meets the requirements.
We're going to fly the SLS system in 2018. And between now and then, we're going to fire this motor. Less than a year from now, we'll fire the 2nd qualification motor. And then we'll start assembling that Space Launch System rocket in Florida, launch in 2018. And the 2nd flight of that rocket motor will take astronauts further into space than we've ever been.
From there, we're now into the proving ground, where we test the ability to be distant from Earth by days and weeks, and getting ready for the long-term exposure to deep space that gets us ready for a Mars mission in the future.
Planet's been through one ice age. History tells us it'll go through another. So we really do need to get out there and explore to find other planets that are Earth-like that we can survive on.
So they say the journey of 1,000 miles begins with the first step. In this case, our journey is millions of miles away to Mars, and we're starting to take these steps. The next step is going to be this QM motor firing, and we're really getting excited to see it.